It's a really awe-inspiring moment to see something that you've made go and fulfill its destiny.
Today, NASA will be launching our CubeSat called SUSAT, which is our first satellite that our university has ever built. With the miniaturization of electronics, it's brought about this new type of spacecraft, which is called Space 2.0, which is nanosatellites, and that's small satellites. So it's about the size of a loaf of bread, and it's packed with sensors, so it can do a large number of the jobs that the larger satellites could do, but at a much reduced cost. So since 2013, we've had around 50 students working on this project. So we basically made our own systems, bought some systems, integrated it all together, checked that it functioned properly, did a whole lot of environmental testing, and then packed it up and sent it over to Europe.
I am enrolled into this project in an honours capacity where Matthew Tetlow, who's the head of the project, was my supervisor. My role was looking at the control of the satellite and keeping its orientation steady in space.
Our satellite has two payloads on it, and one of them is called an ion and neutral mass spectrometer, and that basically just measures density of particles in the upper atmosphere. In addition to that, we have an occultation experiment, which is basically uses GPS measurements to work out how much water vapor is in the atmosphere.
It was quite humbling to be a part of something like this and to know that the university could offer this kind of opportunity to students to work alongside people who are directly working with spacecraft, which will ultimately be launched into the atmosphere.
It'll be very exciting to see it launch, to actually know that our spacecraft is in there and watch it, you know, lift off and hopefully have a successful flight up to the space station. That'll be a fantastic milestone to hit, and to get this far, you know, is a testament to the team, really. It's been a difficult ride, but you know, it's been invaluable to many, many students and staff members, I think.